led a U.S. intelligence official to file a whistleblower complaint. The Washington Post reports that the president made a promise that was so troubling to this official, it prompted the official to report it. And even more importantly, it prompted the intelligence community inspector general, a Trump appointee, to deem it was of urgent concern. Joining us now, John Avalon, CNN senior political analyst, and Rachel Bates, CNN political analyst and congressional reporter for The Washington Post. A Trump appointee, the inspector general, thinks this complaint is of urgent concern, of such concern that Congress needs to know. But, John, the big questions are, what was the promise? To whom?
Yeah.
And what does it say about the president's notion of intelligence?
What it says about the president is that the president of the United States appears to be a security risk. The intelligence community is concerned that the president can't be trusted with classified information and occasionally goes beyond that. This dates back to early days of the administration. Remember, it was May of 2017 when the president disclosed classified information to the Russian foreign minister. And that began a pattern of deep distrust with the intelligence community.
Which compromised our allies, by the way.
And arguably assets. So this has been part of a larger pattern. And here you also see another pattern, which is you have an acting DNI, an acting director of national intelligence, caught in between the urgent concerns of this whistleblower, and which have been confirmed by the inspector general, and his fealty to the president. And this has also created a real concern, because where's the accountability between the branches of government? Will he be able to actually disclose what information is out there? Because this Washington Post report is a bombshell, and more information is needed for the simple role of oversight in a republic.
Rachel, we've been talking about how things might come out today. That obviously, there's a lot happening with this story, and the inspector general is going to Capitol Hill today to appear in front of the House Intelligence Committee. What will he say about this?
You know, I think John hit it right, the nail right on the head right there, talking about the accountability and other branches of government. I mean, there's a legal requirement that whenever this sort of whistleblowing happens and whenever this notification is given about top secret information like this, that within 7 days, DNI, the agency, is supposed to notify Congress of exactly what the complaint was. Now, that didn't happen after this came up in August. Lawmakers only heard about it a couple of days ago. And Adam Schiff, who is the chairman of the House Intelligence Committee, he's furious about this. And today, obviously, the inspector general is going to be in front of him in a closed session. They're going to press him for more information about what this complaint was, who was Trump talking to, what exactly did he say. But again, this shows this really breakdown of the system that we've been seeing in Washington for the past year and a half. And that is that Congress is trying to do a bunch of oversight of the administration. A lot of these scandals that are coming out, these controversies, and they're not able to do it. And this is just another example of that. Schiff has not been able to get answers. We'll see if he will today. But, you know, the executive branch right now, they're just not following a lot of traditional procedures when it comes to checks and balances and different branches of government holding each other accountable.
I do want to come back to the mystery promise in a second, John. But, Rachel, what you're saying here also plays into what we saw over the last 2 days on Capitol Hill with Corey Lewandowski's testimony, his non-answers. And you have new reporting that Nancy Pelosi didn't like what she saw one bit.
No, she told some lawmakers at a private meeting last night. They were complaining about how disrespectful Lewandowski was to the committee on Monday. And she said, look, if I was there, I would have held him in contempt of Congress right then and there. Now, lawmakers had talked about that when, you know, Lewandowski was dodging questions, when he was interrupting them, when he was promoting his Senate bid and his book sales. But they decided against it. You know, the committee wanted to keep the focus on the president. And so they decided not to do that, although they could at a later date. But again, this just sort of highlights the challenge that the committee has really had in trying to hold out and show the public parts of the Mueller report in this specific case. It just turned into a circus and angered people. And that, you know, that became the story.
I almost held him in contempt yesterday here on New Day.
If only you were vested with such powers.
Well, yes, I often, well, every day wish that. But Rachel, what did they learn? Was there a lesson from the experience with Corey Lewandowski where moving forward, if they want to continue doing this in public, they are going to adapt to, you know, reluctant witnesses?
You know, I don't know that there was a lesson because everybody's taking something different. I mean, I talked to Democrats yesterday who were upset about the circus-like atmosphere that it created. They said it made them look weak, Democrats, it made them look weak because they didn't hold in contempt. I talked to pro-impeachment folks, including Jared Huffman, who's a California Democrat and is very supportive of the impeachment movement, who said hearings like this, it's not going to sway the public. This is not going to change any hearts and minds. But, I mean, if the Judiciary Committee really wants to do this, if they really want to impeach Trump, they don't really have a choice right now. They've got to get the witnesses they can actually get. And that sort of limits, the administration has very much limited them and who they will allow them to speak with. So, you know, they went for Lewandowski and they're going to try to grab some others to try to move that polling.
John, I just want to play a little sound for you from yesterday back to the intelligence issue here, which shows how the president might feel about secrets.
Yeah.
Listen, he's at the wall.
One thing we haven't mentioned is technology. They're wired so that we will know if somebody's trying to break through, and you may want to discuss that a little bit, General.
Sir, there could be some merit in not discussing that.
Okay. I like that.
Points for honesty. Look, I think you see the extraordinary impulse of a general being like, let's not go there, Mr. President, because guess what? The cameras are on, and that's classic. You get a sense that this could be a president who, if he's a security risk, is just one who stumbles into it through loose lips. But the implications are a lot more serious. And that's why there needs to be transparency. There needs to be accountability. This isn't about Adam Schiff getting answers. It's about the American people getting answers.
I mean, by the way, one last thing on this. The president uses an unsecure cell phone. Or at least he did until a year. The last reporting we had on this was from Maggie Haberman, which was a year ago. He uses an unsecure cell phone.
What could possibly go wrong? This is against the backdrop also of just normalization. We're getting used to behavior that is irresponsible, bordering on dangerous, or people showing outright contempt for Congress. And it's being baked in the cake, and that's a real danger. That's why it needs to be accountability and clear lines. Someone acts with contempt, you hold them in contempt.
And one more thing, a foreign country knows what promise was made.
Yep.
But the United States, Congress, no.
Okay. And let's just remember just a couple of years ago, you know, just a couple of years ago, we were writing about, you know, Hillary Clinton and her email situation and how just some communications had some classified information on it. She wasn't sending that information to somebody abroad or a foreign official or anything like that. Here you have the president saying something that is classified to, you know, potentially a foreign adversary, scaring the intelligence community so much that they're blowing the whistles internally. And again, this normalization that we're starting to see with these sorts of things, you know, a Democrat said to me yesterday on the Hill, if another president had had one of these scandals, they would have been impeached by now.
I do remember when candidate Donald Trump seemed quite upset about what he was seeing with Hillary Clinton, and times have changed. Okay.
Here we are.
Thank you.